Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today I am going to show you how to install latest version of PostgreSQL on the Windows operating system. And after that, I am also going to show you how to use this latest version of PostgreSQL for SQL programming. So first you need to go to favorite browser and to type over here PostgreSQL download. Hit enter. So that will show you this postgre.org. So just simply go to their official site. So this link I'm going to provide right in our channel description, and you can see that our latest version of PostgreSQL, that is version 18, is released. So you need to switch to your respective operating system. If you're using Linux or Mac OS or Windows or BSD or Solaris, you need to proceed with that. I'm using Windows, so I'm going to click on Windows. And that's going to redirect to this Windows installer. So this link I'm going to provide right in our channel description. Here we'll get this link called download the installer. So when you click on that, it's going to redirect to this page. So here you can see the latest version of PostgreSQL is version 18. So again, depending upon what operating system you are using, you need to proceed with the download link for Windows. I'll just simply click on this download button, and immediately it will show you this page and your download will get started shortly. So you can see it is rightly started downloading. I have already downloaded it, so that's why I'm going to cancel this. I'll minimize my browser. I'll go to my download directory, and here you can see that PostgreSQL is already been downloaded over here, and the file size is 354 MB. So this is what we need to install. So just simply double click on that installer. It will ask if I administrative privileges. Click on yes, and you can minimize your download directory. And our PostgreSQL is rightly started opening. Here you need to just simply click on next. So this is where our PostgreSQL is going to be installed. Totally fine, keep it default and click on next. So these are all components that it's going to also install along with PostgreSQL. So I'll recommend you to keep it default. Do not change anything. We are going to also talk about this pgAdmin 4 at the coming part of the video. So I'm going to show you how to use they had this GUI interface of pgAdmin 4 for doing SQL programming. So everything I'm going to show you, just keep watching. So just simply click on next. So this is going to be our data directory. Again, totally fine. Click on next. Here you need to set your password and need to remember this password every single time you're logging into PostgreSQL. So always provide a password that you can remember. So I'll provide one sample password, and I'm going to repeat the same, and I'm going to click on next. So this is going to be our port, this 5432. Again, this is a very important when you are trying to establish your database with your application. So that time you need to establish that connection always. So that time this port is very useful. So this is the default port of PostgreSQL. So again, keep it default, click on next. Locally also I'll recommend you to keep it default and click on next. So it's ready to be installed. Click on next, again click on next, and our installation is rightly begun. So this installing PostgreSQL will take some time, about couple of minutes. So let's wait for that, and once when it is done, I'm going to again come back to this video. So we'll come back. So now you can clearly see that our PostgreSQL is rightly installed. Also this tag builder option is rightly checked. So let's talk about brief about this tag builder. So click on finish. So that will launch our tag builder. So welcome to tag builder. So here you can select your server. So we are using PostgreSQL 18, that is on port 5432. So you can select that server and can proceed with next. So that's going to start downloading all the application lists. So here you can see under categories, we have all these different categories. So you can expand these database drivers, and you can see all these different drivers. You can expand to database server as well, and you can see all the older versions of PostgreSQL server are also available. So 18 is the latest version which is currently installed, but if you want to downgrade it to some older version like 17, 16, 15 and so on, so that also you can do. You need to just downgrade it. So stack builder will basically give you that flexibility. You know, you don't need to again go to their official site in order to download some older version. So you can do literally everything from stack builder. So if your project requires some database drivers, So like this PG, JDBC or PSQL, ODBC and everything, you can see those are all already present. You can add, you know, add some add-ons from here, or if you are into web development, you can install all these different, you know, drivers from here. So that, you know, feature you have. So it, so that's what Stack Builder basically provides you. Alright, so you just select it and proceed with next. So I'm going to cancel this as I'm going to proceed with latest version of PostgreSQL only. So now that my PostgreSQL is actually installed, so let's do a bit of coding. So go to search and type pgAdmin, and I'm going to show you this pgAdmin 4. Open that. So our pgAdmin 4 is rightly started opening. Here is our pgAdmin 4. So we'll maximize this. And there you go. So this is our pgAdmin 4 GUI interface for PostgreSQL. So you can expand the server, and that will ask you to connect with server. So remember the password that we have given while installing PostgreSQL. So you need to provide that exact same password, and you can save that password also. So for that, just check that and click on OK. And now you should be again connected to PostgreSQL server. You can see it is connected, right? So you can expand this database, and you can see already you are having a default database called PostgreSQL. So let's see how you create a new database. So for that, you need to select this main database and right click and hover over create and click on database. So here you need to provide a database name. So let's give the database name as players. Can give any database name. All right, I'm just giving a demo. So give players and click on save, and it's going to create a one new database called players. So now we have two databases, one is players and the default one is PostgreSQL. So we'll be working on players, that is our database. So select players, right click and click on this query tool. So here it's going to create a blank sheet over here. So here you can write your queries. So I'll start with creating a database. So create table, sorry, I'll start with creating a table. So create table, let's say chess players. So I'll give a bracket and I'll give couple of column. So one column will be ID of integer type, and another column will be of name of varchar type of 50 characters, let's say. So you know, just write this much, end with a semicolon, and when you select this and click on this run button, so that's going to start executing our script, and you can see a table is created. So next, let's insert some values to our table. So insert into chess players, which has couple of column called ID and name, and then we are going to put some values onto that table. So values, let's give ID as 1 and name let's give as Gukesh, our current world chess champion, and I'm going to select this and I'm going to click on execute script. So you can see it is returned successfully. So similarly, let's insert one more value to our table as well. So just this time replace the ID with 2. And let's make our future world chess champion as Prago. So again, select this, click on execute, and it is returned successfully. Also insert one more value. So don't forget our former world chess champion Vishwanathan Anand. So we'll also I'm going to insert Anand, click on execute, and it is inserted. So now it's time to check our table. So you can do select star from chess players and end with semicolon and select this and click on the run button, and there you have your table. So Gukesh, number 2 is Pragu and 3 is Anand. So that table is properly created. So in this way you can easily install PostgreSQL and can start working on your SQL programming right on pgAdmin 4. Please do mention if you need more videos on SQL, I'll be happily making more videos. Meanwhile, you can start watching cool Python project playlist. All these videos like one of the videos is this rock paper scissors game, or how to deploying a Python Flask app to some web server, that too for completely free. Or let's say you want to build your very own resume builder, so it will literally give you some forms, so you need to fill those forms, and on clicking generate resume, it's going to generate a resume, PDF resume, just like the screenshot you can see over here. So this one is a desktop application and this is a web app. So similar to that, you can see I have created a lot of videos, so you can watch all these different videos. And the best part is source code for all these projects are also available on our official geekyscript.com website. So you can read the explanation along with detailed video are also available over here. So you can check all those out. I'm sure you're going to love them. So that's basically all about this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.